Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to read the poem Mother and the Mouse by the poet Faith Trickson. Today's lecture will consist of four basic components: the structure of the poem, the summary of the poem, its theme, and the devices that the poet has used within the text. To begin with, as far as the structure of the poem is concerned, it's a short poem that consists of 11 stanzas, and each of the stanzas in turn contain 4 lines. That is to say, the poem consists of 11 quatrains. Each of the quatrains are made up of lines of equal length wherein alternate lines rhyme. Let's move on and try to summarize the text. The poem opens with the poet describing and highlighting the power and strength of his mother. The poet says that his mother is not afraid of darkness and not even of thunder. She is a strong woman. The poet also shows how his mother has raised her. Further, the poet informs the reader how even the look of her eyes are enough to check him in case he misbehaves. After giving us a brief glimpse into his mother's character, the poet begins to narrate an incident from his life. One morning, as he woke up, he found his mother, strong mother, screaming at something from the kitchen. The object had so terrified her that she was now sitting on the kitchen sink. The poet begins to question as to what could have terrified her thus. And he finds out, to his utter surprise, that it was a mouse that had scared her out of her wits. The poet soon shoos away the mouse with a broom and begins to comfort her mother. And this entire episode makes him feel like a superhero, having rescued his mother from a terrible creature. As far as the theme of the poem is concerned, there are two important themes that the poet tries to communicate through this simple, humorous poem. The first and the most prominent theme of the poem is the relationship that the poet tries to depict between a mother and her child. The poet shows how the mother is able to control her child even with the look of her eyes, and how the child manages to save her mother from a mouse that has scared her to death. The second important theme of the poem is, through this important, beautiful text, the poet tries to highlight how each of us have our own shares of strengths and weaknesses. Let's move on to the devices that has been used within the text. As I've already informed you, within the poem, alternate lines are rhyming, and therefore there are a number of new rhyming words within the poem. For example, shiver, quiver, stare, dare, dream, scream, and so on. The poet has also made use of alliteration, a figurative device. That is, in my mother, there is repetition of ma sound, darkness doesn't, repetition of da sound, mighty mum, repetition of ma sound. Apart from alliteration and rhyming words, we also find that the poet has made use of similes and comparison. For example, squealing like a baby, trembling like an autumn leaf, she whimpered like a baby, I felt like a superhero, like superheroes do. One of the most important things that I noticed within the text is how the writer has put two contrasting ideas side by side. The opening stanzas present the mother as a brave and strong woman, while the remaining stanza depict her frailty and her weakness. That is all for the poem class. Thank you so much.